promise, you shout about a promise, you get all these words of prophecy, you make preparation for it, you see it begin to happen, you begin to shout and testify, then all of a sudden it fall apart. It's hard for you to stand unless you know that this is only temporary. God's going, this is just something I got to go through because God's going, this thing is already going to happen. See, Peter got himself in a situation where he thought that Jesus had failed him. The very person who said they would take care of you turned out to be a failure. Am I here by myself? The very person you trusted in, who was doing all the talking, who told you what they would do, and showed you what they was able to do, and testified about what they could do, and then when you needed them the most to stand to keep you going, they walked away. Or you looked at them and saw their weakness. And everything that they said to you looked like it was a lie. Am I here by myself? Oh God, I'm preaching real good. I don't know, y'all ain't probably never been dealing with people as long as I am, but since I turned 26, I look back all my life and I have dealt with a lot of people. And I understand the one thing about people is that they will fail you. Can I say it again? The one sure thing you know about people is that they're going to be people. They're hard and they're cold. And particularly the ones who make you the biggest promises, be careful of those ones. Amen? So let me get back to this. Here's my message for you, gentlemen, love this morning. It's easy to quit right now at the pressure that you're under. And I know I'm not the only one under here in pressure. Because the reason why a lot of people, the members of the church, are not here because they're under pressure. You understand? The pressure is too much for them. The devil's talking in their head. And the thing you have to understand, if you want to walk in victory, you have to understand if God said it, he's able to do it. You got to live your life knowing that God is able. Yes, this looks bad. Yes, it looks like a failure. Yes, I don't feel good. Yes, I don't like the way this is. Yes, I don't like what they're doing. But if God said he's going to do it, God's going to... Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Shut up, bullshit. If God said it, so you got to stand on a foundation that God is faithful. And then you got to live life full of expectation. I am giving you something that in the midst of your darkest hour, if you apply it, it's going to make your journey easier. In the midst of the darkness, David said that word is a lamp under my feet and a light under my pathway. So when you're going into your toughest time and it looks impossible, you don't have no money, the light's off, the rent due, the bill's due, and there's no money. In the midst of all that, you got to remember that God said, I shall supply all of your need. You got to remember that God said, I've given you money. You have an abundance of money. I've ordained people to bring you money. You got to... Oh. That's right. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus, amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's it. We under attack right now. The enemy is fighting because he don't want you to get this word, but I'm going to preach this anyway. Somebody say amen. Amen. You have to understand what God promised you. Hallelujah. You got to remember what he promised you. Your inheritance are the promises of God. You are no different from anybody else. It's going to look, times are going to look like you're losing. Hallelujah. And too many people walk away because of what it looks, but you walk by faith and not by sight. And faith cometh by hearing. And hearing by the word. I hear the Lord saying to me, loud and Charles, I'm looking for some people who will trust my integrity. Who will not let everything and anybody outside of me control what they do, contrary to my word. Amen. God, help me here right now. It's so easy to do. I told my wife last night, I talked to somebody who go to this church and they was out of town having a good time and just trying to find reasons not to come to church because they're discouraged. But I told her, I understand that. Because if you don't understand faith and you're part of ministry like this one here, if you don't understand what faith is, you're not going to make it. Because the warfare is too intense. Too many people's lives are changed here. Too many people have been healed here. The warfare here is too intense. And if you don't understand this is God's doing and not you, and maybe allow you to be tested. If you don't know how to stand as if God said it, I stand to lead it. Glory to God, I'm here by myself. If he said it, I'm fully persuaded. If he said it, he's going to be able to do it. So I'm not going to be shaken. I'm not going to speak against it. I'm going to stand giving him the glory. Am I here yet? Here's the point I got to make. You have to live a life of expectation. You have to live a life full of hope. Because when you become a hopeful person, you become anointed people who don't have faith. So when you're in the midst of your darkness and your mess, and you're speaking victory, people don't understand that. They think you've lost your mind. The devil don't even understand you. But all that pressure on you, you get up and say, I still believe God. You have to wake up every day. Can I give you all some tidbits? You have to wake up every day as a hopeful person. Because if you believe God, you're going to live a life of hope. And then when you live a life of hope, you're going to have expectations. So if you're hoping that God doing it, you will expect him to do it. And when you expect him to do it, your expectations are going to determine the steps that you take. Because if you expect him to do it, you won't know what is that required to be in place when it's done. I'm preaching good with you. I'm preaching real good. You have to maintain your hope. Because yes, the enemy is an expert at making things look impossible. That's why I keep going back to Abraham, who against hope. That means you was hopeless. Anybody in there facing a hopeless situation?